After another brief swim through the depths, they emerged into a land completely bereft of life, of love, and heart and soul, with the kindness of man, just a rumble of machines and a lunatic master plan. Machines, machines, how they scorched the earth, flattening everything that grew, leaving little hope of rebirth. An empty, barren land lay in their wake. No birds, no plants, no animals, just one huge mistake. Some machines were digging, some were filling in, but it takes more than mud and dirt to cover certain sins. And as the boy approached one enormous trench, his dog stopped in his tracks, overcome with the stench. Knolly's head hung low, and a growl rose in her throat. The hair stood on end all across her silky coat. Four paws planted firmly, no further would she go, and so it was up to Phoenix to see what lay within the hole. Slowly and unwillingly, like his boots were made of lead, he walked closer to the edge, his heart filled with dread. He covered up his mouth and nose so he wouldn't breathe the smell. He felt like he was looking at the darkest depths of hell. Images of people spilled into his mind, like a tidal wave of loss and despair of every kind. Families and friends torn apart and destroyed, lives ripped asunder and flung into the void. What happened here? How had it come to this? What story could dream up this unholy abyss? What hand had orchestrated horrors such as these? Could there be a cure for this maniac's disease? All these flames extinguished, all these fires doused, all these hopes and memories now quiet as a mouse, empty, but for one boy and his dog, with hearts sinking, and machines, 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 incapable of thinking. These glimpses into other worlds had opened up his eyes. These worlds were not unlike his own, he began to realize. Now with little hearts broken, but lessons fully learned, they turned and faced the sun and the home for which they yearned.